لهم جبين مولد جبل من النعيم المقيم الذي عذب له
ياسر هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بعاد إرم ذات العماد التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فصب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب إن ربك لبالمرصاد فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمن وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانن كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم ولا تحاضون على طعام المسكين وتأكلون التراث أكلا لما وتحبون المال حبا جما كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا وجيء يومئذ بجهنم يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي يومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي صدق الله العلي العظيم.
السلام عليكم. بسم الله جابر صاحب. माइक आपका म्यूट है, अनम्यूट करें.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. سهم حرم میں خون کو بہنے نہیں دیا احسان یاد رکھے گا کعبہ हुसैन का
ऐनक परिचय रखो
है शर्मसार आज भी नस्ले यजीद की है खर्जदार आज भी कूफा हुसैन का मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया बेकसी का शह की चर्चा रह गया मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया इस खदर था खुश्क हजरत का गला इस खदर खुश्क हजरत का गला खंजर खातिल भी प्यासा रह गया खंजर खातिल भी प्यासा रह गया मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया जब हुई बेपर्दा औलादे रसूल जब हुई बेपर्दा औलादे रसूल फिर जहां में किसका पर्दा रह गया फिर जहां में किसका पर्दा रह गया मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया फैज था बेपर्दगी में आल की फैज था बेपर्दगी में आल की हम गुनहगारों का पर्दा रह गया हम गुनहगारों का पर्दा रह गया मुजरई मेहमान प्यासा रह गया बेकसी का शह की चर्चा रह गया। सलवात पर मोहम्मद वाले मोहम्मद अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मोहम्मद वाले मोहम्मद।
بسم الله غش جم غش جم رزبي بسم الله
रहमान आय का मुझे रिसाइटेशन करनी
है जी। बिस्मिल्लाह बिस्मिल्लाह।
अच्छा मैं सॉरी मुझे आवाज नहीं आ रही थी आपकी। एक बार मिल के बाबा से बुलंद सलावत तामील हुकुम में कलाम आपके सामने पेश कर रहा हूँ इमाम ज़मान के हवाले से। काबिले गौर है ये जरा सोचो तो काबिले गौर है ये बात जरा सोचो तो अलवा जल कहते हो दिन रात जरा सोचो तो काबिले गौर है ये बात जरा सोचो तो तुमसे पूछे वो अगर मुझको बुलाते क्यों हो तुमसे पूछे वो अगर मुझको बुलाते क्यों हो मुझको बुलाते क्यों हो किस तरह दोगे जवाब जरा सोचो तो काम ऐसे ना कर जिससे अजियत हो उन्हें काम ऐसे न करो जिससे अजियत हो उन्हें जिससे अजियत हो उन्हें वो भी रखते हैं हिसाब जरा सोचो तो कुछ दिनों के लिए मेहमान हो इस दुनिया में कुछ दिनों के लिए मेहमान हो तुम दुनिया में मेहमान हो तुम दुनिया में इससे आगे के मकाम जरा सोचो तो इससे आगे के मकाम जरा सोचो तो मौत के पंजे से
बच ही नहीं सकता कोई, मौत के पंजे से बच ही नहीं सकता कोई, बच ही नहीं सकता कोई, सब गुजरेंगे ये हालात, जरा सोचो तो। मंजिले कब्र भी, बरज़ख भी है महशर भी है, मंजिले कब्र भी बरज़ख भी है महशर भी है, महशर भी है। कितने हैं नेक अमल सार, जरा सोचो तो। जब भी मुश्किल कोई दरपेश तुम्हें आती है, जब भी मुश्किल कोई दरपेश तुम्हें आती है, दरपेश तुम्हें आती है, कौन होता है सदा साथ, जरा सोचो तो। अपने आमाल से किरदार मुनव्वर हो अगर, अपने आमाल से किरदार मुनव्वर हो अगर, किरदार मुनव्वर हो अगर, कितनी आसान है मुलाकात, जरा सोचो तो। हम अमल में भी हैं, शिया के फकत नाम के हैं, हम अमल में भी हैं, शिया के फकत नाम के हैं, के फकत नाम के हैं। खुद से करते ये सवाल, जरा सोचो तो। हम हकीकत में अली वाले ही कहलाते हैं, हम हकीकत में अली वाले ही कहलाते हैं, अली वाले ही कहलाते हैं, क्या वो हम में कमाला, जरा सोचो तो। ज़हन नाक़िस है, बयां क्या हो फजीलत शाया, ज़हन नाक़िस है, बयां क्या हो फजीलत शाया, बयां क्या हो फजीलत शाया, वो है सुल्तान कमाला, जरा सोचो तो। अल अजल कह तो दिन रात, जरा सोचो तो। काबिले गौर है ये बात, जरा सोचो तो।
برای تعظیم از ظهور منتقم کربلا با صدای بلند صلوات الله
احسنت احسنت تقبل الله ಮಡಿ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಂದಗೊಂಡು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ಆಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಈಗಲೇ ಸಿಸಿಬಿ ಪೊಲೀಸರು ತಮ್ಮ ವಶದಲ್ಲಿ أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الأطيبين الأنجبين بهم نتولى ومن أعدائهم نتبرأ إلى الله اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. In the wasiyat that we have for Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam, it's quite a lengthy one. And in part of that wasiyah, Imam says, لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ أَسَاسِ وَأَسَاسُ الْإِسْلَامِ حُبُّنَا أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ, that everything has a base, and the base of Islam is the love towards us, the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. This mahabbat to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam is mahabbat to Rasulullah, is mahabbat to the existence of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It is that reward that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks from the nation, from that is that love towards the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. There are some mics that are open. Can you mute them on, please? Now, one of the muhabbat that can be portrayed to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam is by the ziyarat of the ma'sumeen, and in particular, ziyarat of Sayyid al-Shuhada Husayn ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi as-salam. So much of weight it carries, so much of ajr and reward it carries, that for example, in one of these quotes that we have from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi as-salam, he meets one of these companions in Medina and says, do you pay a visit to my grandfather Husayn? He in reply says, I don't, because I live in Medina and that's so far off, and I cannot travel to Karbala so frequently, so often. Imam says, you do not need to travel. Just look at your right, look at your left, and say, As-salamu alayk ya Aba Abdullah, As-salamu alayk wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And for that one sentence, you get the reward of one complete Hajj and one complete Umrah. That is for the ziyarat. Now, when we see this ziyarat, or even the uttering these small sentences of people traveling to the ziyarat of Sayyid al-Shuhada, Allah, now here this hadith is from Kamil al-Ziyarat. There Imam says, Man arada Allah bihil khair qadhafa fi qalbihi hubba al-Husayn wa hubba ziyaratih. If Allah wants the good of someone, he installs the love of Hussein and the love of the ziyarat of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein in his heart. And if he wants the bad of someone, there he installs the hatred towards Hussein and towards the ziyarat of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein in his heart. Now this question may come to one's mind that it is Allah who is ultimately playing the role over here with no free will and wisdom and freedom. That is not the case. This question was asked from the Ma'asum alayhi salam. Imam says in reply that ash-shaqiyu man shaqiya fi batni ummih. An evil is someone, or wretched is someone who is wretched in the womb of his mother, and likewise prosperous is someone who is prosperous in the womb of his mother. Now a person comes to Imam al-Kazim and inquires that how come, if everything is known bad and good, then what role does it play that this person has any free will or freedom? Imam in reply to this statement says, "Ash-shaqiyyu man 'alima Allah wa huwa fi batni ummih." That is Allah, he's got all the knowledge, although this person, like for example Yazid, is in the womb of his mother, and there he knows Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala what is he going to do. So that is that knowledge of Allah which is being meant over here. It says ash-shaqiyyu man 'alima Allah wa huwa fi batni ummi shaqi, or this wretched is someone for whose knowledge Allah has, although that person he hasn't been born yet. Likewise, prosperous and Sa'id is someone, knowledge of that is with Allah, Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So these things we have to give importance to, and that is one of the statements that we have, and that is from Bilal bin Hamama, one of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says that one day the Prophet was very happy when he came to us. Abdul Rahman bin Auf says, why are you so happy, Ya Rasulullah? He says that the day the Almighty intended to wed my daughter Fatima to Ali alayhim as-salam, he instructs an angel to shake the Tuba tree. Tuba is a tree in the heavens. Says Allah, says, shake that tree in the heaven, and he shook. Leaves with something written on them fell from that tree. Angels were created to collect those leaves on which some note was written, and then says that on the day of judgment, these angels with those notes will spread amidst the gathering of Mahshar and give this note to each one of the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Now what is written on that note? Says, Bara'atun lahu min an-nar min akhi wabna ammi wabnati. Says, salvation from the fire, protection from the fire, or from my brother and from my cousin and from my daughter. Like a wedding card, wedding invite that is given out, says that is what is written on that leaf. فَكَاكَ رِقَابَ رِجَالِ وَنِسَاءِ مِنْ أُمَّتِي مِنَ النَّارِ. Protection of men and women from my of my nation. And all of that due to that love and mahabbat a person has to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. And repeatedly it has been mentioned that what Quran states regarding mahabbat is that إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. If your claim is that you love Allah, you have to be obedient to Allah, you have to be obedient to Rasulullah, you have to be obedient to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Only then that love will be true, and we will benefit a reciprocal love from the other side as well. So mahabbat is important, and then towards the Ahlul Bayt and to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Now this love to the Ahlul Bayt, hubbuna Ahlul Bayt, yukaffiru az-zunub wa yudha'ifu al-hasanat. It sheds the wrong, the sins that we have done, and it increases and magnifies the hasanat, the good that is done. Now Yazid says that in the presence of Imam Baqir alayhi salatu wassalam, a person came all the way from Khurasan. Now Imam is here in Medina, and Khurasan, Iran, so far away. He says that upon the arrival, he shows his feet to the Imam, all cuts and bruises and wounds and blisters on his feet, and said, Imam, this is your love that dragged me to you all the way here to Medina. In reply, Imam says, Ama wallah, ma ja'ani min haythu ji'tu illa hubbukum ahlal bayt. That what you drag me to you was this love to you, the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Imam in reply says, Wallah law ahabbana hajarun hasharahu Allah ma'ana. Says, even a stone, if he loved us, he will be raised with us, the Ahlul Bayt. So this muhabbat, it's very important. And what we see in Karbala is the muhabbat that the ashab of Imam Hussein alayhi as-salam, they portrayed towards Sayyid al-Shuhada, otherwise out of the entire population of the globe at that time, only 72 accepted to serve the noble cause of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. As many as 40,000 wrote to him from Kufa, and then all of them rejected, all of them denied that invitation of Aba Abdullah to Kufa. Now, from the entire planet, only 72. No wonder we see that on the night of the 10th of Muharram, there Aba Abdullah, when he turns the light off and he
Imam alayhi salam jab ja rahe the kab
me. Now that was regarding the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Now when we see the ashab of Sayyid al-Shuhada, Nafi bin Hilal Muradi is one of Bajli is one of the ashab that is there in Karbala. Among the ashab of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, he joined Imam Hussein's caravan when Hur stopped him. Nafi with three of his men reached. Hur said, "You can't join the Imam alayhi salam." Imam said that they are with me, they were with me, but they have joined late, they arrived late. Nafi is one among those men who brought water to the camps two times or three times to the camps of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. And on the night of Ashura, Imam gave a sermon and asked all those who want to leave to go. Nafi stood up and said, "Wallah, ma karehna liqa'a rabbina. By God, we don't fear death. We are prepared to fight. We are prepared to sacrifice ourselves to you, Ya Aba Abdullah." And one who does not fear death, no threat fears him. Imam's companions were all brave, were all strong. Their utmost desire was, how many more of the Imam's enemies can we remove from the surface of this earth, and how longer can the Imam live? So the utmost endeavor of all of the Ashab was that the Imam, he lives longer, a few more breaths, a few more moments, a few more seconds of his life be increased. Now, and he then said that, "O son of the Prophet, Ana Ali, inna ala niyatina wa basairina, we have joined you with a vision, with an insight, and our intentions, they are all pure, they're all divine. Everything that is with awareness, it's strong. And if you accept deen, that also has to be with awareness, with an insight. And if it is the prayers that we offer, that too has to be with awareness, with insight, with an understanding. Participation in majalis also is similar. That is, we come to a majlis with an insight, with a vision, with an understanding that we have participated. Now, whether it be in a majlis present in a Husseiniya, in a Matam, in a Masjid, in an Imambara, or whether it's like what we have today, that is, that mindset has to be that we are in the presence of the Ma'sumeen alayhim assalam, and that way we find the productivity of that action, it magnifies, it increases, that deen, that majlis, that prayer, all of that is different. That is why never accept deen with ignorance. Now, when we see the ashab of Aba Abdullah, this one that was just mentioned, he says, "Nuwali man walak wa nuadi man adak." That is, we love all those who you love, and we hate and we distance and we disassociate with everyone who you are away from. So tawalli and tabarri, tawalla or tabarra that we have, and generally it is listed in the Furu'ud-Din. In reality, tawalla comes in the Usul-Din. That is, you have to have that love to Allah first, and then automatically that hate towards shaitan has to be there. So this love and hate of haq and batil always goes together and hand in hand. Now, one of the other things we have to be extra cautious and extra careful when it comes to haq and batil, many a times people, they think that haq and batil is only in the religious side of affairs. That is wrong. Haq and batil in everything. Allah has given talents. Allah has given charm to someone. Allah has given a power to speak to someone. Allah has given a pen to someone, or maybe he's given a beautiful voice to someone. And likewise, all the talents and sciences that a person has, if we spend them and if we invest all of these talents, whatever they are, on the path of haq, on the right path, we are safe. If we don't do that, then know for sure, and it is definite, that it will be spent in the way of batil. There is no gray area, there is no third option, that if I don't do this and if I don't do that, there will be a third option. No. It is either Ali, a person picks, or Muawiyah. There isn't a third option. When you look back into history, you've got loads of examples. One of them can be mentioned over here is Abdullah bin Umar. He is the son of the second Khalifa, renowned to be extra pious, over pious, and also reports the ahadith from the Prophet more than the ahadith that have been reported by Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he was with Rasulullah right from his birth until the demise of the Holy Prophet. And then he hasn't reported that many ahadith that Abdullah bin Umar, the son of the second Khalifa, reports. Now this person, after the Khilafat of Uthman, and it is the Khilafat of Amir al-Mu'mineen, he does not swear an allegiance upon the hands of Amir al-Mu'mineen, nor Muawiyah. He comes and says that, I have a shubha here, I am going to be cautious and an ihtiyat, so I don't know whether haq is with Ali or haq is with Muawiyah. So he sits down. And after both of them, it is the turn of Yazid. He also is silent over here. And then in the rule of Yazid, Yazid appoints Hajjaj bin Yusuf as the governor of Kufa. One night, this Abdullah bin Umar, he comes to the house of Hajjaj bin Yusuf. It was past midnight, knocks at the door. The caretaker, he opens the door and sees that it is this very noble and very pious person. Then says that, why at this time? Says, I have to meet the Khalifa right now. It's extremely urgent. He says, you could have waited till the morning. He says, I couldn't. Comes in and shows him into Hajjaj bin Yusuf, gives him the message that this is the son of the second Khalifa, this very renowned pious person. He's come to see you and right now. Now, that time, Hajjaj bin Yusuf was in bed. Says that, okay, show him in. He comes into his bedroom and he was lying down. Says, what is the urgency of this meeting? Says, I have heard this hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Man mata wa lam ya'rif imam zamanihi mata mitatan jahiliyya. Someone who dies not knowing the imam of his age has died a death of ignorance. And I fear that I don't survive till the morning. And I know that you are the imam, the rightful imam. I've come to swear an allegiance on your hand. Hajjaj says, I'm too tired now. I can't get up. I can't give you my hand. You can swear that allegiance on my foot. And he just shows his foot. And this very extra pious person, he swears an allegiance on the foot of Hajjaj bin Yusuf. How silly a person could be, how unfortunate a person could be if he does not swear an allegiance on the hand of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. He has to swear an allegiance on the foot of Iblis, on the foot of Shaitan. So that is what is being mentioned over here, is that it's either haq or batil. There is no third way. Likewise, all these talents that Allah has given to every one of us, those talents also have to be spent in the path of haq. If we don't do that, definitely they will be spent in the path of batil. One of the other ashab of Imam Hussein alayhi salam is Ali bin Qirza, a young man, Ali bin Qirza. He got martyred on the day of Ashura. His brother Amr bin Qirza, so it's two brothers. Ali is with Imam Hussein, got martyred with the ashab of Imam. His brother Amr bin Qirza, he comes and says to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, "Adlalta akhi," that is, you deviated my brother. Imam replied, in fact, your brother was guided. You are the one who is misled. He replied, I don't care. I won't live but to kill you. And came to attack the Imam alayhi salam. Here Nafi' bin Hilal, he strikes and sends him to hell. So Nafi' had 12 spears in Karbala, killed 12 people from the enemies. And when he had no more spears, he fought with his sword and he killed so many. Both of his hands were broken and he was attacked from behind and then severely wounded. He was arrested and he was taken to Umar al-Sa'd. And Umar al-Sa'd said, Shimr, you kill him. Shimr drew his sword to kill him. Now Nafi' says, Alhamdulillah alladhi ja'ala manayana ala yadi ashrar khalqih. That is, all praise be to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, who has made our death through the hands of the worst of his creation. So these are the supporters, staunch supporters of Abu Abdullah, as long as they lived, even in the presence of the enemies. Now what gives them the strength? It is this bonding with Abu Abdullah. It is that bonding with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Because the Quran says that whoever says Allahu Mawlana, he is the one who is prosperous. He's the one who is successful. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُتَّقُونَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ مُؤْمِنِينَ They are the prosperous. Now this Nafi, when he came to the front, his slogan was, in its first phrase, he introduces himself. And then second, he introduces his association towards the religion. That is important, that whoever I am, my identity is my name, whoever, what the descendant of I am. And at the same time, my association to whatever has also to be portrayed, has to be said. It says, أَنَا الْغُلَامُ الْيَمَنِيُّ الْبَجْلِي دِينِي عَلَى دِينِ حُسَيْنِ ابْنَ عَلِي That I am that servant from Yemen. Bajli is the last name. And then, دِينِي عَلَى دِينِ حُسَيْنِ ابْنَ عَلِي My religion is upon the religion of Hussein ibn Ali. أَضْرِبُكُمْ ضَرْبَ غُلَامٍ بَطَلِي وَيَخْتِمُ اللَّهُ بِخَيْرٍ عَمَلِي And I will attack, I will fight ferociously here. And my end also, it's going to be good. And that is because of my actions, which are connected to Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. So throughout we see that among the ashab of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, this tawalla is there, this tawarra is there. And we love... We have to love three things. The first thing, it's our aqidah, our faith that we have in Allah, and then those personalities who bring forth this ideology, this belief, that is the Ahlul Bayt, alayhim as-salam. And then we love their actions. That is, if I am with the Ahlul Bayt, it is because of their actions. I love their actions, I also will be raised with them. So someone, he comes to Allama Amini, the author of Al-Ghadir, that great alim who died in the late 60s or early 60s and who has written this book on Al-Ghadir in 40 volumes. Someone comes to him and says that we love God, we love the Prophet, and we love the Imams, alayhi wasalam. What if we do not love Abul Fazl al-Abbas, alayhi salam, what? So I've loved the Allah, Rasulullah, the Imams, but not Abul Fazl. Will that be a problem? In reply, this great alim says, Abul Fazl, if you don't love me too, your deen is faulty, because I am a servant of this deen. And Imam Sajjad also in du'as, we see the same thing. As'aluka hubbak, that Allah, I want your love. Wa hubba man yuhibbuk, and the love of everything that you love. Wa hubba kull amalin yusiluni. Ila qurbik. This is a dua that Imam has, and the love of everything which brings me closer and nearer to you. That also I want. So that love factor we see all the way through, it has to be very genuine with Allah, very genuine with Rasulullah, with the actions of Rasulullah, and everything and everyone who brings me, it's all these components, they're all connected to one another. So we can't say that, okay, we'll take that many and then we'll put these away. That cannot happen. All of them, they are connected to one another. Usul to furu, furu to persons, to the ma'asumeen, to their descendants, all of them. During the time of Imam Askari alayhi salatu wasalam, a thief was caught stealing. The Abbasis, when they wanted to arrest him, he said, I am a Shia. They said, as mark of respect, because he's a Shia, let's take him to Imam Askari alayhi salam. They bring him to the Imam. And they says that Imam to them says that Shi'atuna humul ladhina yattabi'una atharana. Our Shias, they are those who follow us, who listen to us, who are obedient to us in all commands, and those who obey us in most and in most of the commands of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and those who do not obey them, they are not our Shias. So here Imam also connects this being of Shia, of a person, to the obedience of Allah, to the obedience of the Ahlul Bayt. So a person disobedient to Allah cannot claim that he is a Shia. That's what Imam is saying over here. Now the messages that we get from these slogans of the Ashab of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, they're all based on love and hate. Find out who do you love and hate. The first of the it is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Now, this is what we learn from Ayatul Kursi, where he says that فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالْتَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. So one who disbelieves the Taghut and has faith in Allah. So bring, that we are all being raised with the Mahbub. Our Mahbub is Allah. Our Mahbub is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Now here a person comes and asks Rasulullah, Matasa'a, when is the day of judgment? Rasulullah replied, have you availed everything for the day of judgment? Are you prepared for that day? Here this person says that I'm a very basic Muslim. I don't have much. Says that I offer the prayers, the wajib, not more than that. Mustahabbat, I do not. And my amal, you see that wajib has been done. Mustahabbat are lacking. But I have excessive love to you, Ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah in reply says, Anta ma'aman ahbabt. You will be with him who you loved. And then points at his two fingers that you will be with me and be heaven with me. Now, these are the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, their companions, their followers, their lovers, etc. Now, the topic that we had for today is a little bit on Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, and then talk a little bit on the Ziyarat Nahiyat al-Muqaddasa. Ziyarat Nahiyat al-Muqaddasa, for Abu Abdullah and Hussein, there are many ziyarat, more than 80 ziyarat have been reported for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And we do not have that many ziyarat for any ma'asum, not even for Rasulullah. And after Abu Abdullah and Hussein, we have ziyarat for Imam Rida alayhi salam in Mashhad. Now, for Imam Hussein, we see that on a Thursday, there is a ziyarat. When you want to pay a visit to him from near, there is a ziyarat. From distance, there is a ziyarat. In his haram, ziyarat. On the night of Qadr, on the day of Qadr, on the night of Eid, on the day of Eid, on the night of Arafah, day of Arafah, ziyarat of Imam Hussein in the harams of other ma'asumeen, so many ziyarat. So the major chunk of ziyarat that we have in the books of du'as is related to Sayyid al-Shuhada Hussein ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Now likewise, Imam Asr alayhi salam, when he wants to pay a visit to Abu Abdullah, he's got his own ziyarat. One of them is Ziyarat Nahiyat al-Muqaddasa. Nahiyat al-Muqaddasa, when we say that this ziyarat, it has come from the presence of the 12th Imam. Now this was in the year 252 after Hijrah, that is the era when Imam was in Ghaybat. At that time, this ziyarat was reported by the ambassadors or the representatives of the Imam alayhi salam, and this ziyarat has come from him. Now, when you look into this ziyarat, it is the Masa'ib of Karbala that are recited by Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, Imam al-Asr alayhi salatu wasalam. And in this ziyarat, I just quote a few of these sentences of the ziyarat so that we get an idea. And if you could go through this ziyarat and see the masa'ib recited by Imam al-Asr alayhi salatu wasalam, that how painful the whole situation and the scenario it was in Karbala. So all these are genuine masa'ib from the two lips, Mubarak lips of Imam al-Asr alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, like every other ziyarat, this also starts with the sending salutations and salams to the prophets, like As-salamu ala Adama safwatillah min khaliqateh, As-salamu ala shaysin waliyillah wa khiyarateh. That is, salam be upon Adam, the chosen of Allah, upon his creation, and salam be upon Shays, the friend of Allah, and who is the best. As-salamu ala Idris al-qa'imi bi-hujjatih. As-salamu ala Nuhin al-mujab bi-da'watih. That is, salam be upon Nuh, and whose supplications and his du'as were all accepted. And then continues with sending salams to Prophet Nuh, and then Prophet Hud, then Prophet Saleh, Prophet Ibrahim, Prophet Ismail, and then Prophet Ishaq, Prophet Yaqub, Prophet Yusuf, Prophet Musa, Prophet Harun, Shu'aib, Dawood, Sulaiman, Ayyub, Yunus, and then Uzair, Zakariya, Yahya, Isa, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So all of these prophets were mentioned as Imam sent salams and salutations to them all. Now comes and says, As-salamu ala Muhammadin Habibillah wa safwateh, salam be upon Muhammad, the beloved of Allah and his creator and his chosen one. As-salamu ala Aliyin Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib al-Mahsusi bi quwwatihi. That is, salam be upon the chief of the believers, Ali son of Abu Talib, distinct by his brotherhood. And then as-salamu ala Fatimah al-Zahra ibnatih. Salam be upon Fatimah al-Zahra, the daughter of the Prophet. And then salam be upon Abi Muhammad al-Hasan, the executor of his father's will and his successor. And then says, As-salamu ala al-Husayn al-Ladhi samihat nafsuhu bimuhjatih. Salam be upon Hussein, who sacrificed himself and his life to Allah. As-salamu ala man ata' Allah fi sirrihi wa alaniyatih. Salam be upon the one who obeyed Allah secretly and openly. And then says, As-salamu ala man ja'ala shifa'a fi turbatih. That is, salam be upon him in the earth of whose grave Allah has granted cure. If you happen to go to Egypt, inshallah, there is this Masjid Ra's al-Hussein in Cairo, and there is a huge haram they have made, the Egyptians, for Abu Abdullah, because they believe that the head of Sayyid al-Shuhada is buried there in Cairo, and it's called Masjid Ra's al-Hussein. When you want to enter that masjid, on the two sides of the entrance, huge, big, they have written, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn. That is the saying of Rasulullah. And when you come in, there is a big zarih that has been made. And on the zarih also, the statement has been written that, As-salamu ala man ja'ala shifa fi turbatih. That is, salam be upon him on the earth of the grave of whom that Allah has granted shifa. And then this has also been written there, As-salamu ala man al-ijabatu tahta qubbatih. Salam be upon the one under the dome of whose acceptance has been written. As-salamu ala man al-a'immatu min zurriyatih. Salam be upon him in whose progeny imamat has been bestowed. So these three were these specialities and special graces and bestowals of Allah Jalla wa'ala to Abu Abdullah al-Hussein for the sacrifice that he gave. That is, dua is like a blank check. You go under the dome of Sayyid al-Shuhada. Whatever you want, you ask, it is given to you. And the imams, they are from the progeny of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. And then the shifa has been bestowed in the dust of the grave of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. And then continues with the salams to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and comes to the point and says, As-salamu ala ibn Zamzam wa Safa. Salam be upon you, the son of Zamzam and Safa. As-salamu ala al-murammali bid-dima. Salam be upon the one who was soiled with his blood. We don't see such statements to any other imam, any other ma'asum, that salam is being sent and said to all these different parts of the body of the imam. Rasulullah, you say, As-salamu alayki ya Rasulullah, ya Nabiyyallah. Or the other imams, it's the same. For imam, it is as-salam to the imam himself, and then as-salam to the blood that dropped, as-salam to the head individually, as-salam to the beard, as-salam to the body that was soiled and drenched in blood, all different kinds of salams. And here says, As-salamu ala al-mahtuk al-khaba. That is, salam be upon the one whose tents were torn. As-salamu ala khamisi ashab al-kisa. Salam be upon the fifth one of the companions of the cloak. As-salamu ala ghareeb al-ghuraba. Salam be upon the lonely of the lonely. As-salamu ala shaheed al-shuhada. Salam be upon the martyr of the martyrs. As-salamu ala qateel al-ad'iya. Salam be upon the one killed by the enemies. As-salamu ala sakini Karbala. Salam be upon the one, the inhabitant of Karbala. As-salamu ala man bakathu malaikatu sama. Salam be upon the one, the angels of the sky, whom they wept for him. As-salamu ala man zurriyatuhu al-azkiya. Salam be upon him whose progeny they're all purified. As-salamu ala ya'su bid-deen. And then Imam comes to a point and then says, As-salamu ala shifa hizzabila. Salam be upon the parched lips due to the thirst that was seen in Karbala, and all of the members of the caravan of Abu Abdullah, they were thirsty. Lips were all parched, lips were all broken. Here Imam says, Salam be upon those parched lips. As-salamu ala nufus al-mustalamat. Salam be upon those inevitable souls. As-salamu ala al-arwah al-mukhtalasat. Salam be upon those souls that were all seized away. As-salamu ala al-ajsad al-ariyat. Salam be upon those uncovered bodies. As-salamu ala al-jusum al-shahibat. Salam be upon the lean bodies. As-salamu ala dima is-sa'ilat. Salam be upon the blood that flowed. As-salamu ala al-a'dha al-muqatta'at. Salam be upon the severed limbs. As-salamu ala ru'us al-mushalat. Salam be upon those heads that were all raised. As-salamu ala al-niswat al-barizat. Salam be upon the women who were in the open. As-salamu ala hujjati rabbil alameen. And Imam continues with this salam to Abu Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam, and then comes salam to Ali al-Kabir, that is Ali Akbar alayhi salam. As-salamu ala al-radhi' al-saghir, that salam be upon the infant, the younger. And as-salamu ala al-abdan al-saliba, salam be upon the bodies that were all uncovered. As-salamu ala al-itrat al-qariba. Salam be upon the household, the nearest. As-salamu ala al-mujaddaleena fil-falawat. Salam be upon the abandoned in the desert. As-salamu ala al-nazihina al-awtan. As-salam be upon those who were driven away from their homes. Madinatul Rasul was the homeland of Abu Abdullah. From that place, he was driven away. And then Imam says, As-salamu ala al-madfuneena bila akfan. Salam be upon those who were buried without shrouds. As-salamu ala al-ru'us al-mufarraqati an al-abdan. Salam be upon the heads which were severed from the bodies. As-salamu ala al-muhtasib al-sabir. As-salam be upon him who accounts his actions for Allah and the patient. As-salamu ala al-madloom bila nasir. Salam be upon that oppressed who had no helper. As-salamu ala sakin al-turbat al-zakiyah. Salam be upon the one who is settled in the purified land. As-salamu ala sahib al-qubbat al-. And then continues saying, As-salamu ala man tahharahu al-jaleel. Salam be upon him who Allah Jaleel, he purified. He was purified by the glorious. And salam be upon him Jibreel was proud of. Salam be upon him who was spoken in the cradle by Mikael. Because when Abu Abdullah al-Husayn was an infant, and then when he used to cry, and Hazrat Fatima salamullah alayha, she was tired and she was asleep. Here Mikael comes and sings and puts the baby to sleep. And that is that mannaghahu fil mahdi. Mikael, salam be upon the one who was spoken in the cradle by Mikael. As-salamu ala man nukithat dhimmatuh. Salam be upon the one whose allegiance was broken. 40,000 invited, all of them rejected, and Imam was left alone, stranded here. As-salamu ala man hutikat hurmatuh. Allah gave an honor, a sanctity, a ni'izzat to Rasulullah and to the Ahlul Bayt, and this was all lowered by these mala'een, by all what they did in Karbala and prior to Karbala in Medina after the demise of Rasulullah. There says, As-salamu ala man uriqa bid zulmi damuh. Salam be upon the one whose blood was shed unjustly. As-salamu ala al-mughassali bidamil jurah. These statements can be said only and only by a ma'soom. No one else can say that. Says, As-salamu ala al-mughassali bidamil jurah. Salam be upon the one who was washed with the blood of his own wounds. As-salamu ala al-mujarra'i bika'sati al-rimah. Salam be upon the one who was attacked with spearheads. As-salamu ala al-mudham al-mustabah. Salam be upon the inflicted whose blood was permitted. As-salamu ala al-manhuri fil-wara. Salam be upon the one who was slaughtered in the open. Now, wara, in Arabic, it has two meanings. Wara, it can be evident in the open. So Imam was beheaded, was slaughtered in the open. One other meaning that we have for wara, wara means behind. That is, he was beheaded from behind his neck, and that mal'oon shimr when he comes to behead Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam, maqatil, they say that he stabbed Imam 12 times and then he removed the head of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. And then says, As-salamu ala man dafanahu ahlul qura. Salam be upon him who was buried by the villagers who were nearby, the qabila Bani Asad, who came and assisted Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, and they buried the bodies, the pure bodies. And then says, As-salamu ala al-maqtu' al-wateen. Salam be upon the one whose jugular veins were all severed. And here when we look at these statements and the wasiyyat of Hazrat Fatima, when she had said that, Zainab, I have a wasiyyah, and this is the shirt of Hussein. A day will come when he will ask you for this shirt. When he does come, this shirt be given to him. I have a wasiyya, and that is, I want you to kiss the neck of my son Hussein. And then she says that, mother, I did that wasiyya. I fulfilled and abided by what I had promised to you. But then on the day of Ashura, when Imam was beheaded, I went and I kissed the veins of the neck of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Says, As-salamu ala al-muhami bila mu'in. Salam be upon the supporter with no helper. As-salamu ala shayb al-khabib. Salam be upon the beard that was dyed in his blood. As-salamu ala al-khad al-tarib. Salam be upon the blood-smeared cheeks. Then when we recall the masaib, Imam was attacked on his heart by Harmala la'natullah alayhi. He attacked with a three-headed arrow onto the chest of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Now this three-headed arrow that he had come with, spear that he had come with, Imam couldn't remove it from the front. He had to remove it from behind his back. Now here, when blood started to gush out for the first time, Imam holds it and then it gets filled. Imam throws it to the sky. And for the second time, Imam holds it again and then says, this time he rubs it onto his face, on his beard, and says, this is how I will meet my grandfather when I see him. Here Imam says, Imam al-Asr in this ziyarat nahiya, says, As-salamu ala al-khad al-tarib. Salam be upon the blood-smeared cheeks. As-salamu ala al-badan al-salib. Salam be upon the uncovered bodies. As-salamu ala al-saghr al-maqru'i bil-qadib. Now in the palace of Yazid, la'natullahi alayh, all that disrespect that he was showing to the pure head of Imam, when he had that baton in his hand, that stick in his hand, and with that stick he poured the remaining wine from his cup onto the pure head of Imam, and with that stick he was hitting the lips and the pure teeth of Aba Abdullah. Here Imam al-Asr recalls that in this ziyarat and says, As-salamu ala al-thaghr al-maqru'i bil-qadib. Salam be upon the teeth that were hit with a baton. As-salamu ala al-ra'si al-marfu'. Salam be upon the head that was raised. السلام على الأجسام العارية في الفلوات. Salam be upon the bodies bare in the desert. تنهشها and then السلام عليك يا مولاي وعلى الملائكة المرفرفين حول قبتك. Salam be upon you, my master, and upon the angels that gather around your dome. Now here there are angels in Karbala. If you recall the Maqtal, the Imam, when he everyone had passed away and he was all alone, there the angels, they come to extend their help. Imam denies and rejects them. Now here the jinn, 4,000 of them, they come. Imam rejects them, denies them, sends them away. Now these angels who had come to support and to help Imam on the day of Ashura, they remained here in Karbala and they are in the haram of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein night and day, praising and glorifying. When you got that many angels in that beautiful site and that shrine of Ma'asum, how is it possible that a dua be done there, be requested there from Allah and that not be accepted? Such a pure and such a beautiful environment that is the haram of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. May Allah the Baraka wa Ta'ala help us understand these great sayings of these ziyarat. And the second, this is just the, I recited maybe less than 1/4 of this ziyarat. Towards the end of it, that is when the whole battle starts, and then Imam, he sets off to the battlefront, how he fights, all of that has been mentioned. And post-Karbala, that is after the Shahadat, how this caravan was taken from one place to the other, all of that has been mentioned by Imam alayhi salatu wassalam. And inshallah, if an opportunity is given, we'll continue with that ziyarat. Ilahi, بحق الزهراء وأبيها وبعلها وبنيها والسر المستودع فيها يا الله 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 اللهم أحينا حياة محمد وآل محمد وأمتنا ممات محمد وآل محمد اللهم ارزقنا في الدنيا زيارة محمد وآل محمد وفي الآخرة شفاعة محمد وآل محمد. إلهي, between us, Quran and Ahlul Bayt, never ever come across a moment of separation. إلهي, a share of this majlis and this ma'rifa that was increased and enhanced be delivered to the marhumeen of every one of us, in particular the organizers of this majlis. إلهي, the first Shia from among our ancestors, whoever he was, whenever he was, a share of this majlis and the ajr of it be delivered to him. All those who are ill and ailing, ilahi, by Sayyid al-Shuhada, Husayn ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, grant them shifa. Allahumma ajil fi faraji maulana sahib al-zaman matami Husayn. Bismillah wa sabda.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي آمنت بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
السلام السلام عليكم
آپ کو اصلا میری آواز آ رہی ہے تاکہ مجھے معلوم ہو جائے کہ آیا ہماری آواز
وعلیکم السلام ورحمۃ
اللہ وعلیکم السلام ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ
جی جی بہت شکریہ بہت شکریہ ان شاء اللہ عزیز میرے ساتھ علی عمار موجود ہیں جو آپ کو آپ نے دیکھا بھی ہوگا ان شاء اللہ کہ اس سال بھی اور پچھلے سال بھی اور دعا ہے خدا کی بارگاہ میں کہ جناب فاطمۃ الزہرا سلام اللہ علیہا ان کو یہ توفیق دیں کہ یہ اپنے وقت کے امام امام زمانہ عجل اللہ تعالیٰ فرجہ شریف کے ذکر کو خلوص دل کے ساتھ اہل بیت کی بارگاہ میں ان کو توفیق ملے کہ وہ خلوص دل کے ساتھ اسی طریقے سے یہ ذکر امام زمانہ اور امام حسین کرتے رہیں الہی آمین ایک بار تمام مومنین کی خوشیت و سلامتی کے لیے دعا کی قبولیت کے لیے بر محمد وآل محمد سلام
اللہم صلی علی محمد وآل محمد واجعل فرجہم
اس سال کا پہلا کلام آپ کے سامنے میں پیش کر رہا ہوں اور مالی میرے ساتھ پیش کریں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
اے فاطمہ تلال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ تلال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کلال تیرا غم منائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کلال تیرا غم منائیں 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 گے حور کی قسم سبھی لوگ یاد حسین میں
حور کی قسم سبھی لوگ یاد حسین میں
حور کی قسم سبھی لوگ یاد حسین میں یاد حسین میں یاد حسین میں دشمن کو بھی حسین کے پانی پلائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کلال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کلال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کلال تیرا غم منائیں گے
اے فاطمہ کلال
تیرا غم منائیں گے غازی کی آرزو ہے علم یہ رہے بلند
غازی کی آرزو ہے علم یہ رہے بلند
غازی کی آرزو علم یہ رہے بلند
علم یہ رہے بلند علم یہ رہے بلند
عباس کی قسم یہ علم ہم اٹھائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کی لال تیرا غم منائیں 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 گے عباس کے علم سے نہ ہوگی کبھی جدا
عباس کے علم سے نہ ہوگی کبھی جدا
عباس کے علم سے نہ ہوگی کبھی جدا
کبھی جدا
پرچم کے ساتھ مشک سکینہ سجائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
اے فاطمہ
کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
باقی ہے جو
نماز یہ روزہ یہ حج زکاۃ
باقی ہے جو نماز یہ روزہ یہ حج زکاۃ
باقی ہے جو نماز یہ روزہ یہ حج زکاۃ
یہ روزہ
یہ حج زکاۃ یہ روزہ یہ حج زکاۃ احسان یہ حسین کیا کیسے بلائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کی لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کی لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
اے
فاطمہ کی لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کی لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
جب تک
امام عصر رہیں گے حجاب میں
جب تک امام عصر رہیں گے حجاب میں
جب تک امام عصر رہیں گے حجاب میں رہیں گے حجاب میں انتقام خون کے آنسو بہائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ ماں کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
دیکھے
گی کربلا کی زمین ہوگا جب ظہور
دیکھے گی کربلا کی زمین ہوگا جب ظہور
دیکھے گی کربلا کی زمین ہوگا جب ظہور
ہاں
ہوگا جب ظہور ہاں ہوگا جب ظہور در کی ذوالفقار محمد چلائیں گے روزے ازل کی آتا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں 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 گے
لارے بہ
یہ وعدہ نہ جائیں
یہ وعدہ نہ چاہیں گی فاطمہ
نعرہ بھی ہے یہ وعدہ نہ چاہیں گی فاطمہ جنت میں جب تلک نہ آزادار جائیں گے روزے ازل کیا تھا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے 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 اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
لا رہے بے
ہے یہ وعدہ نہ جائیں گی فاطمہ ہے یہ وعدہ نہ جائیں گی فاطمہ
لا رہے بے ہے یہ وعدہ نہ جائیں گی فاطمہ
جنت میں جب لگنا آزادار جائیں گے روزے ازل کیا تھا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں گے
جب اذن دے
امام زمانہ فرید ہم اذن دے امام زمانہ فرید ہم
جب اذن دے امام زمانہ فرید ہم
جب اذن دے امام جب اذن دے امام
مظلوم
کربلا کی زیارت کو جائیں گے روزے ازل کیا تھا جو وعدہ نبھائیں گے اے فاطمہ کے لال تیرا غم منائیں 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 گے
پر محمد وآل محمد سلام
اللہ
محمد معلوم ہو جائے کہ ہماری آواز آ رہی ہے تاکہ ایسا نہ ہو کہ اب انشاءاللہ علی عمار آپ کے سامنے پچھلے سال کا ایک اور کلام آپ کے سامنے پیش کر رہے ہیں جو ہر مومن مومنار کی خواہش ہے کہ اگلے سال نیکسٹ ایئر انشاءاللہ عزیز امام حسین کی زیارت اسی سال ہم کو زیارت میں سے نصیب ہو من عاشق حسین عمار انشاءاللہ عزیز یہ شروع کریں گے بسم اللہ عمار
من عاشق حسین من ظاہر حسین من عاشق حسین من ظاہر حسین من عاشق حسین من ظاہر حسین نمش میرے لہو کی کہتی ہے مجھ ہے نوحہ دل ہے میرا محرم میرا تمام گریا آہو بھوکا مجسم میرے ہر ایک نفاس میں ہے شور ماتم عاشق حسین انا من عاشق حسین من ظاہر حسین عشق کربلا ہوں یہ دل ہے کربلائی مولا ہے میرے مولا ان کا میں ہوں فدائی ماتم کی گونج سارے عرض و سما پچھائی میرے لہو نے ہر عاشقِ حسین من ظاہرِ حسین من عاشقِ حسین من ظاہرِ حسین
پیاسوں
کے جتنے غم ہیں یہ سارے غم ہیں میرے صحرا ہو یا کہ مقتل لاش قدم ہے میرے یہ سب جلوس ماتم آہو شمع ہے میرے
یہ سب جلوس
ماتم
چاہو
شمع ہے میرے
یہ قافلہ
میرا یہ سب ہے ke Husaina, man aare Husaina, man aashiq ke Husaina, man zaire Husaina.
Har ek nafas ko maine zaire bana diya hai.
سہرات کربلا پر
سر کو جھکا دیا ہے
سہرات کربلا پر
سر کو جھکا دیا ہے مقتل کے راستے پر دل کو بچھا دیا ہے ان کی زمین پہ میں نے خیمہ
لگا دیا من عاشق حسینا من ظاہر حسینا من عاشق حسینا من ظاہر حسینا
یہ دل ہلال مجھ کو کر آن بان دیتا لال مجھ کو کر آن بان دیتا میں بھی بنا میں اکبر کچھ امتحان دیتا ان کی رضا جو ہوتی مقتل میں جان دیتا قطرہ میرے لہو کا اٹھ کے آسان
دیتا من عاشق حسینا من ظاہر حسینا من عاشق حسینا من ظاہر حسینا اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى
محمد واجل
محمد میرے پاس ابھی ٹائم کتنا ہے مجھے بتا دیجئے تاکہ میں اسی حساب سے پھر میں آگے کلام پیش کروں
بسم اللہ بسم اللہ
انشاءاللہ میں آپ کے سامنے کلام پیش کروں اس دعا کے ساتھ کہ خداوند عالم اپنی بارگاہ میں ہمارے اس ذکر کو اپنی بارگاہ میں قبول مقبول فرمائے اور ہمیں وہ درد کربلا در سے امام حسین بھی یاد رہے. آئیے مل کر کربلا کے جہاں پہ ہم ذکر امام حسین کرتے ہیں جہاں پہ ہم گریہ زاری کرتے ہیں وہاں پہ ہمیں کربلا کو بھی یاد رکھنا چاہیے. حیا علی خیر العمل
خیر العمل
ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ تمہیں حسین صدا دے مقتل سے آزاد کا فرش بچھاؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ دادے رہے ہیں مقتل سے آزا کا فرش بچھاؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز
کے ساتھ
عالم بنا رہا تمرد ہم دمے آباد نشاں ہمارا آباد ہے پرچم آباد تقاضا کرتا ہے تم سے یہ ماتم احباب علم ضرور اٹھاؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ ہماری یاد مناؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ عزا کا فرش بچھاؤ مگر نماز کے ساتھ آئیے ایک اور کلام پیش کروں آپ کے سامنے اسی خلوص دل کے ساتھ ماتم کے دن میرے ساتھ شریک رہیے گا اللہم ارزقنا شفاعت الحسین اللہم ارزقنا زیارت الحسین اللہم ارزقنا شفاعت الحسین الہی امین اللہم ارزقنا زیارت الحسین کہاں یہ کار بدر کارواں روانہ ہے کہ ان کے ساتھ میں خود صاحب زمانہ ہے بلا رہا ہے انہیں فاطمہ کے دل کا چین اللہم ارزقنا شفاعت الحسین اللہم ارزقنا زیارتنا شفاعت الحسین اللہم ارزقنا زیارت الحسین صدائیں ہائے حسینا کی بڑھتی جاتی ہے صدائیں ہائے آئے حسینا کی جدید وقت کی سانسیں اکھڑتی جاتی ہے پیام موت کے ظالم کو یہ عزائے حسین اللہم ارزقنا شفاعت الحسین اللہم ارزقنا زیارت یہ کربلا ہے کہ اسلام جس سے قائم ہے ملائکہ پہ بھی جس کا طواف لازم ہے زمین پہ عرش معلی ہے کربلا حسین ارزقنا الحسین اللہم ارزقنا زیارت الحسین ظفر لا کوئی ایسے بڑا اساسہ ہے کہ ذکر نہ میرا ہوا شاہ حسین ہے اللہم ارزقنا شفاعتہم ارزقنا زہران امام الزمان میں ہم کو شامل فرمائیں آئیے مل کر اس آخری دعا کے اندر دعا امام الزمان کے اندر کہ جو ہر مومن کے دل کی آرزو ہے ہر مومن کے دل کی خواہش ہے کہ پروردگار پورا عاش و دور کے اندر یہی دعا ہے کہ میرے مامو جسد ہمارے امام کا ظہور ہو اور ہم اس کے لشکر میں شامل ہوں آئیے مل کر دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے انشاءاللہ مار شروع کریں گے اور اسے ہم کو ساتھ ساتھ بسم اللہ
دعا کرو
کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ شاباش
تمام دنیا ہو اختیار کے نشانے پر
شاباش
او ساری خلق خدا موت کے دہانے پر
او ساری خلق خدا موت کے دہانے پر
جو غیر خدا امام ہو جائے
ماشاءاللہ یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ سینہ کی نوک پاؤں شاباش کفن ہوا کا ملے گا نہ خاک کا بستر
اجل شاباش پھر لاش مرحبا
اجل چباتی پھرے لاش مرحب و انتر جو ذوالفقار علی بے نیاز ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام شاباش دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دوبارہ سے دعا کرو کہ ظہور
امام ہو جائے
روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو کرے گی موجِ ہوا زمین بند کرے گی فرار کا رستہ وہ برسے آگ جو درباریوں وہ برسے جو درباریوں کو ہو سکتا زبان فدک ہم کلام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا شاباش ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام حقیقی صورت نگاہ ابھی
زمانے کی
شاباش
ہوگی
ایک ہی عذاب ہوگی پھر کلمہ یہاں ایک ہی عذاب ہوگی
امام ہو جائے
یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز
تمام ہو جائے
وہ جن کے دم سے ہے قائم امام دین مبین وہ جن کے روزے سے روشن گئے سامرا کی زمین وہ جن کے روزے سے روشن گئے شام کی وہ زمین اب ان کے روزے کی جانب بڑا ہے دشمن دین اب ان کے روزے کی جانے بڑا ہے دشمن دی اس اب رہا کبھی جینا حرام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام رہے جو پیاسے لبے جو انہیں ابد کا سلام قلم جو ہو گئے بازو انہیں ابد کا سلام جو ان کے غم میں ہے آنسو انہیں ابد کا سلام جو ان کے غم میں ہے آنسو انہیں ابد کا سلام خدا کرے کہ شروع انتقام ہو مل کے پڑھیے خدا کرے کہ شروع انتقام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا قصہ تمام ہو جائے دعا کرو کہ ظہور امام ہو جائے یہ روز روز کا
قصہ
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم كل وليك حجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائك في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة
ولي
شراش
وقعدا ولا سراش
ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرزك توعى وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم خدا کی بارگاہ میں دعائیں میرے معبود جو واسطے ذکر کا ہم سب کے سننے کو پڑھنے کو اپنی بارگاہ میں قبول و مقبول فرما اے رب العزت جو واسطے جتنے شہداء جتنے مرحومین ہیں بالخصوص میرے مرحوم والدین اس کا جتنا اجر و ثواب ہے میرے معبود میرے مرحوم والدین کو تمام شہداء کی روح کو سال فرما اور خدا بند عالم تیری بارگاہ میں یہی دعا ہے کہ پروردگار ہماری آنے والی نسلوں کے اندر اس ذکر کو خلوص دل کے ساتھ برپا کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرما تمام مومنین کا خصوصاً برادر آغا شیر حضرت شرازی کا میں بہت شکر گزار ہوں کہ جن کی محبتوں کا شکریہ ہے کہ جنہوں نے مجھے اس ذکر کے اندر شامل کیا حضرت شرازی کے لیے آغا حضرت شرازی کے لیے بہت تہ دل سے دعا گو بھی ہوں کہ خدا ان کی توفیق میں اضافہ کرے والسلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ
بہت شکریہ جزاکم ربکم رزقنا اللہ زیارت الحسین شفاعت الحسین فی الدنیا والآخرہ انشاءاللہ التماس دعا آپ سب سے اللهم ارزقنا زيارة الحسين
محتاج دعاء محتاج دعاء
شفاعة الحسين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن وجب له حق علينا ولمن وصانا بالدعاء ولجميع أمة محمد وآل محمد السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين السلام عليك يا صاحب الزمان يا شريك القرآن السلام عليك يا إمام الإنس والجان عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل الله مخرجك وظهورك ورحمة الله وبركاته لأرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات الفاتحة مع الصلوات اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد